acting. And are you okay? You okay? You okay, yeah. And are you okay? You okay? You okay, yeah. And are you okay? You okay? You okay, yeah. And are you okay? You okay? You okay, yeah. And are you okay? Cause you jealous. Are you okay?
Okay, I'm psyching myself out. I got an interview in 2 minutes.
Waiter's always looking at me and thinks that I'm going to have a salad, maybe a soup, and that'll be the whole meal.
So, when should I join this meeting? Like, should I join 2 minutes early? Should I not? See my face. It's time. I'm just gonna join. Alexa, stop. Nobody's here. Is it recording?
There she is.
Hello.
Hi, Crystal.
I guess I was in the wrong one.
Yeah, no, we kind of changed it up a little bit.
Oh, okay.
So you know Sergio, correct, Crystal, or no?
I've met him a couple times, but that was years ago. Hi, Sergio.
Okay.
Hello.
Okay, so we'll start. As you know, you're interviewing for the customer service representative senior position, and it's new to our department. We do have seniors, well, they're called seniors in the billing department, but this is a new position that we'll be developing if you're chosen, you'd be part of helping us determine what the position will become.
Okay.
Duties and things that for supervisors and, you know, more than what you're doing now.
Sure.
Do you have any questions before we start?
I don't know. I think maybe if I understand, was there more than one being opened, or that was just what I overheard?
We're hoping it will be more than one. For now, it is just the one at this point.
Okay.
Hopefully it's real successful, and we are able to make it more of a step up within the department. There are 10 questions. We will be writing, so, you know, don't feel like we're ignoring you, but our heads will be out. We'll be writing the answers.
Okay.
If you have any questions or, you know, during the interview, just don't be afraid to ask us, okay?
Okay.
And I'll start with the first one. Let me know if you need me to repeat anything. It's kind of a long one.
Okay.
So, question one. Describe your experience in a customer service and billing environment. Include example of duties you performed that required your analytical skills and why you feel you are the one for this position.
My experience in the customer service position that I'm in now is very much diverse in a lot of different subjects, so it could be on any typical day. It could be from billing questions to business license questions to escalated upset customers to customers who just want to make a simple payment. So it's a broad variety of things that my brain needs to just constantly be ready for. So if the position was to become available to me, I think I'd be perfect for it because I can think quickly on my feet and I can analyze the situation at hand depending on what's in front of me. So if a customer just wants to make a payment, for example, I don't have to quiz them a bunch about their water usage if that's not what they're there to talk about. They don't want to talk about why their bill is so high. They just want to make a payment. Or if someone does have questions about payment arrangements or they're concerned about something, I can take a little bit more time with them and dig deeper into their account and research what they need. So kind of like fitting my customer service style to fit the flavor of the customer instead of just doing a one-size-fits-all type of style of customer service.
Deadlines you have worked under and the impact if the deadline was not met.
I have assisted in a few projects where there was a deadline to be met, such as working in between calls for a data sheet that needs to be entered into the computer, or if certain information needs to be updated. And if it's not done timely, then it can have a great impact on billing, for example. They need to have their cycles completed by a certain date, or even the customers might be expected to have a certain outcome by the end of the day. And so if I don't meet the expectations, then they could have a serious impact on a few different, three different levels, but it just depends on what the request is or the assignment is.
Have you ever not met a deadline?
Yes, I have. I have had opportunities for growth to learn why I haven't met a deadline, whether it be I can get too detail-oriented on something and get too fixated on the hows and the whys or the cogs of what happened rather than just getting to the outcome. So yeah, I've learned from that though, but yeah, I have not met a deadline before.
Okay, number three. Have you ever been involved in any system conversions, and what was your role?
Yeah, if I'm understanding what a system conversion is, we had a couple in the last few years with Glendale One and SmartGov, and to me, I always find that updating to new systems can be both intimidating and exciting. And so rather than hide behind what always has been or what I'm used to, I'd rather get out ahead of it and learn as much as I can and basically jump in head first, feet first, whatever, you know, just go all in and just learn what I can so that I can soak up as much knowledge and information from the get-go rather than letting it intimidate me the entire time that change is happening. I guess another part of that question is what was my role? Is once I did learn, I did find that I was asked to train others or help others learn based on what I learned. So I would take notes not just for myself, but also on what I wanted to inform my peers with. And so I would create training material or bullet points or just, even though I knew it up here in my head, I wanted to make sure I had it written down so in case they weren't there to see what I saw or learn what I learned, they could follow along with my step-by-steps that I created for myself and for them.
Okay, let's go to number four. Tell us about a stressful work experience and how you handled it.
Well, in customer service, I'd be lying if I say there's never a stressful experience. So I think the biggest thing that I've learned in handling stressful calls or stressful situations, even if it's just with peers or whatnot, it's to breathe and find your grounding techniques. So whether it's just to take a moment to reflect on what you know rather than what you think, or you know, letting someone's opinion cloud your day for the rest of each caller or the rest of each interaction that you have, I find that it's really good to just take a deep breath and work on the facts and then work your way backwards to how are you going to not let this ruin your day.
Okay, give examples of your public contact experience in verbally and written experience.
I'll start with my written experience because prior to working with the city, I had a lot of experience doing communication through emails or letters with the customer. And so when I came on with the city and noticed that the customer service emails, for example, hadn't been addressed in quite a long time, I felt more comfortable handling those as I could through between calls and taking my time to respond thoughtfully and making sure I had the information or sending them links to where they could get more information. So it really helped me learn how to be a better customer service agent. So when the customer was speaking to me on the phone, then I could verbally tell them, because I had so much practice learning about the city through investigating the website or sending people email links or just having a lot of things at my fingertips through writing form of communication. And then once I started working at the front counter for City Hall, that was a new thing because I had been behind the computer desk for so long and behind the computer screen. I had to get over some of my fears and anxiety of speaking to people in person, face to face, which was intimidating at first, but I think with anything, with practice, you get better and more comfortable with it. And the people just want to be listened to is first and foremost. They want to know that you heard and understand their concerns, and then you can reiterate to them on a level where they feel comfortable. You don't have to speak at them or above them. You can kind of just be real with them and talk to them like they're human. So I think I kind of covered all three of those, that part of the question.
Okay, number six. Please give us your definition of customer service and explain what customer service means to you. How do you know when you achieve good customer service?
I am always annoying my kids, for example, on what good customer service is because of our experiences outside of work. So if I go to the drive-thru and someone's not treating me, you know, like a decent person, you know, I'll say, that's not good customer service, and my kids call me a Karen, and they say, oh, Mom, you just think you know everything. And I just laugh because I feel that as a customer myself, I just want to be looked at with eye contact. I want to be treated with respect. I want someone to say, have a nice day, and please, and thank you. I'd like to know what someone's name is in case I want to praise them or give constructive feedback. So I feel that there's so much that gets wrapped up in the customer service. It's not just a position or a role, it's an experience. If you talk to your neighbor, you could have customer service with your neighbor. You could say, hey, how are you doing? And yeah, sorry, my trash fell into your yard. I'd love to, you know, it's more of an interaction. And so I remember when the city started its new mission and its new motto, and how I really loved how they were really focusing. We're not just customer service to our citizens, we're customer service to even each other. So our peers and our supervisors and even, you know, the city manager and everybody in between, even to the janitor, you can smile and can say thank you, you know, hold the door open for someone. It's not just about the job, it's about the experience and how you feel when you're around someone and if they're going to show you courtesy and respect.
So the second part of that, how do you know when you achieved good customer service?
Oh, thank you. I think when you hang up the phone or they start to leave, even if they're not smiling or saying thank you back, it's always good to double check that, is there anything else I can help you with? Or did you have any other questions? Or let us know if you think of anything else. You can, you know, my name is Crystal. I'd like to help you if you think of something that you may have forgotten or something. And then that to me tells me that even if they didn't necessarily give me the exact feedback that I achieved it, I know that I said something towards the end that they might be thinking of down the road that make them go, oh yeah, I remember dealing with that person at City of Glendale and they gave me good service. And when I went to this next company, it wasn't such a warm and fuzzy feeling. So I feel like it's hard for me to know for certain if I've achieved it, but if I know that I've done all I can do, because I know how I am when I leave a company, what does it feel like when I'm done with that interaction, I just try to preside the same thing. So I guess that's how I know I've achieved it, is when I know there's nothing more I can do or say except invite them to come back and I don't mind answering more questions, if that makes any sense.
Yeah.
describe your experience in initiating or writing procedure manuals. Give an example of guest manuals you've written and implemented.
There was a manual when I first started that was written by a fellow employee who was wanting to teach peers or others how to set up new accounts. And this new account manual was several pages long and had a lot of outdated information, but the amount of time and work that you could tell that went into it, I didn't feel like it needed to have the, I didn't feel like the wheel needed to be reinvented. It just needed to be tweaked to be updated. And so it gave me inspiration to do other manuals that were like that. After that one was updated, I took initiative to update that one. And then any other training materials that were needed, I used the same sort of concept with screenshots and arrows and instructions, one, two, and three, and then inside of the instructions, you'd have your bullet points of what to do. And I don't think it was anything official or, you know, approved necessarily, where it had to go to the printers or, you know, had to get edited or, you know, signed off by anybody. But it was basically because we were without, I stepped up to create it because it was needed. And that was the initiative that I felt I could do and I had the ability to do. And I still continue to do to this day, where I feel like I can create material that is needed, because there's the mother of invention is need, right? So because there's something lacking in that spot of the training material that's needed, I felt that, yeah, so I guess if you want examples, there could be, like when a new hire gets started, how to take a payment or how to write a note, what kind of notes are needed for certain types of calls. If they're starting service as an owner, if they're starting service as a tenant, all of those information is different. And then you've got your business training, business license material that I've done for the new conversion last year. And so much more I have. I could probably figure out more, but I don't know if that's over answering the question.
Oh, you gave an example, and you know, we know you have the experience from what you said. So.
Thank you.
Okay, number 8 is the two-parter. This position requires that you're available Monday through Friday, anywhere from 7 to 5:30, and are you able to meet that requirement?
Yes, I can.
And number, or 8B, what examples or strategies would you use to motivate your team?
I find that the best way to get a team to participate is to ask for their input. Because when a leader comes in, whether they're new or long established, nobody wants to be talked at. Nobody wants to be told what to do. Nobody wants this long list of micromanagement expectations. They would like a collaboration where they feel listened to and heard, or their ideas are at least considered. And so depending on what the project is or what the assignment is at hand or what the goal might be, I would probably start with just asking, what do you think? We're going to have to come up with this idea. I have some ideas myself. Do you want to bounce any ideas off and we can maybe come up with a solution? And then once that has been talked about at least, then instead of saying, my idea is this, or this is what I'd like to do for our team, I would say, okay, so we had decided and we had talked about such and such, and we would like to maybe try, give this a try. And if it doesn't work, then we can come back to the drawing board and maybe brainstorm again with some new ideas on how we can get our goal accomplished. But then, of course, as a leader, you've got to keep the ball moving. You've got to keep going. You've got to keep talking to people instead of just expecting it to unfold all by itself. It's got to come from the leader to make sure that the ball keeps moving.
Okay, so number 9, what did you like most and least about your most recent position?
I'll start off with what I liked least. What I think I like least about the position is I feel that not being in a leadership position with my level of passion and I feel like I have a lot of ability. I just don't have a lot of permission to do more. It frustrates me, so I feel very limited. So I feel like I need to go to the leadership quite a bit. I feel like I'm the leadership team quite a bit, and I feel like I'm kind of a thorn in everybody's side. So I have had to quiet down my ideas because I don't feel like I feel like I'm doing more than I should sometimes, rather than just I want to hit the ground running is my passion and where I'm at. What I like most about my position is just how much variety there is in the day. It's not just one thing 8 hours a day. It's several different things that we've had to learn and memorize and just have in the back of our heads, or even if I don't know it, I get excited about figuring it out. And the customer on the other line, for example, will assume that I should just know everything, and I say stuff like, "Well, that's a really good question, and I'm sorry I don't know that right off the top of my head, but let's try to figure it out together." And that sort of energy that the customer can feel for me says, "I don't know the answer. I'm not going to dump you to somebody else or push you off on someone else. I'm going to try to figure this out with you." And I think that's what I like best about my current position, that I don't think is going to go away in any position I do within the city. It's always going to be there, is that figure it out mentality and the variety of my day is what I like the best about it.
Okay, and you asked question. Do you have any additional information you would like us to take into consideration?
I can't think of anything off the top of my head. Other than, I guess, that I think I'm ready for this. There's been a lot of positions that I've applied for within the city over the last several years, but it was more or less a stretch to see if I could do it with the experience that I had. But this one, I know I could do it. Like, I feel like I'm ready for it, and I'm not second-guessing my ability whatsoever. But maybe that's a little too confident.
No.
So just so you know, Crystal, you'll be doing second interviews,
okay.
And they'll be with Lisette and Paul.
Okay.
We, of course, are going to be looking at past performance and reliability will also be a factor when considering who to hire for the position.
Okay.
Do you have any other questions or anything?
I guess we don't know anything about timelines for that second interview or anything, right?
Not yet, but you'll be contacted.
All right.
Okay.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, Crystal.
All right, I'll jump on the phones now.
Okay. Have a nice day.
Thanks, you too. Bye-bye.
Bye.
If I don't get it, it's because of my absences lately. I'm gonna go now. That was kind of a dumb interview. Whatever. Bye!